Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can track conversions in the new version of Google AdWords. We'll cover the dedicated Google AdWords conversion tracking and how this compares to importing conversions from Google Analytics. You'll learn about the different types of conversions you can track, including website and call conversions. And we'll also cover the reasons why you can see differences in the data when you look at conversions inside Google AdWords compared to your Google Analytics reports. Let's get started. When it comes to Google AdWords, we have two separate options for tracking conversions. The first option is to use the dedicated Google AdWords conversion tracking. This is where we configure tracking that is 100% focused on the performance of our Google AdWords campaigns. This is what we'll be covering today. The second option is to import conversions from Google Analytics. This means that we configure the conversion inside Google Analytics and then import conversions from our campaigns back into Google AdWords. Having both of these options gives us the flexibility to choose an option that meets our particular tracking needs. Before we look at how to set up AdWords conversion tracking, I want to cover the differences you might find when you look at the data inside Google AdWords compared to Google Analytics. The differences we see in data are generally the result of attribution. In this example, we can see that someone first came to our website from our AdWords campaign. Then they came from Twitter before finally converting from one of our email campaigns. If we look at the standard attribution inside AdWords, then since there was a click from our campaign in the path to conversion, we'd see a conversion inside our AdWords account. If we then look at the standard reports inside Google Analytics, the conversion would be attributed to the email campaign. So you can immediately see that we'd be looking at different results if we're comparing our data from Google AdWords to what we find in Google Analytics. To set up conversion tracking, let's head to Google AdWords. Click the Tools icon and select Conversions under Measurement. This is where we can configure our dedicated AdWords conversion tracking. And this is also where you can import your Google Analytics goals and transactions. Today, we're going to add a new conversion. This gives us a list of the different dedicated AdWords conversion tracking options we have available. First, we have the option to track website conversions. It's the most common type of AdWords conversion we're going to configure. We also have the option to measure conversions for our apps, phone calls, and even import conversion data. Let's start by looking at website conversions. Once we select to track website conversions, we need to configure our conversion inside Google AdWords. We can see all of the steps we'll need to travel through. First, we need to name our conversion. Today, I'm going to walk through setting up a conversion for tracking a form. So I name my conversion, in this case, contact form. Next, we have the category. The category allows you to classify your conversions inside the Google AdWords interface. So it means that you have the option to select particular categories when you're looking at your campaign data. For example, you can select conversion category when you're segmenting data within AdWords. Now I have the option of assigning a dollar value for the conversion. The first option is to assign the value every time the action is performed. So I can enter the value that my contact form generates each time it is completed. In this example, I'm entering the average value of a form submission, but there are alternate options. If you're measuring real value for, say, online transactions, then you can measure that dynamic or changing value into the AdWords conversion tracking script. You can also use a symbolic dollar value, or in my case, I'm using a calculated value. There is also the option to track the conversion without assigning a dollar value. I really encourage you to try and assign a value, even if it's a symbolic or calculated one. Next, I travel through and I can now decide how I want to count conversions into Google AdWords. My tip here is that if you're capturing leads, then you'll only want to count each conversion once. For example, let's say we're advertising a gym and we have a form that allows people to sign up for a free trial. Once we've captured their details, it doesn't matter how many times they fill out the form, we already have their details. So we're not going to create additional value if they fill out the form multiple times. So in this particular case, we want to count the form as one conversion, even if they complete it multiple times. However, if we were measuring transactions, then each time someone completes a transaction, we're adding additional value. So in that case, we'd want to count every action as a conversion. Now, coming back to my example, I'm going to select one because I'm tracking a contact form and I only want to count a single conversion even if the form is completed multiple times by the same person. Now I can select the conversion window. This tells AdWords how far back in time to look for the person who has converted. The default is 30 days, so this tells AdWords to look back 30 days before the conversion occurred to see if there was a click from one of our campaigns. There's also the option to set the view through conversion window. This is for our display ads and is similar to the conversion window. If someone views our ad but does not click it, then this will be reported as a view through conversion. Setting the window allows to decide how much historical data you include for the view through conversions. You can select if you'd like to include the conversions within the conversions columns inside the interface. In most cases, you'll want to leave this enabled, but if you were setting up tracking for a micro conversion or a secondary objective, then you might want to remove the data for these conversions. This selection is also used to include the conversions in automated bid strategies, including enhanced CPC and CPA or cost per acquisition bidding. Finally, you can select an attribution model for the conversion. This allows you to decide how to give credit for the conversion if someone clicks on more than one of your ads. For example, if someone clicked through on two of your ads, the last click attribution model would give 100% of the credit to the final ad that was clicked before the conversion occurred. You have the option of choosing between last click, first click, linear, time decay, and position-based attribution models. And if you have enough conversion data, you can even move to the data-driven model. Now that we've completed all of the steps, from naming our conversion to assigning value, defining the category, right through to selecting the attribution model, we can save the conversion. We're given the dedicated Google AdWords conversion tracking code. This is the code we need to place on the particular page after the action has been completed. I want to emphasize this is different from Google Analytics. The Google Analytics tracking code is placed on every page of our website, while the Google AdWords conversion tracking code is only placed on the individual page after the action has been completed. So it's quite different. You can also select if the conversion occurs for a particular page on your website or if it's based on a specific click. Now that we've covered how to track website conversions, we're going to look at the other options for conversion tracking, starting with apps. Google AdWords allows to measure app installs and actions within your apps as conversions. You have the option of pulling data in from Firebase, Google Play, or other tracking options for apps. You can select the option you'd like to use and then travel through the configuration options. Next, we have call conversions, which allows you to measure people calling you as conversions inside Google AdWords. There are three options for tracking calls as conversions. If you're using a Google forwarding number, which is an option if you're using a call extension with your ads, then you can track calls as conversions. For example, you can choose to count conversions if someone spends over 2 minutes on a call. The second option allows you to embed the Google forwarding number on your website. This means placing some special code on our website. The code wraps around our default phone number, and now when someone clicks through from our ad, the phone number will be changed to the one that's included within the ad. When they call the number, the conversion will be triggered within AdWords. The final option is to measure clicks on our mobile website. This allows us to measure clicks on our phone number as a conversion. We also have the ability to import conversions into Google AdWords. There are a number of options when it comes to importing conversions. We can import conversions from Google Analytics, Firebase, which is for apps, third-party app analytics, Salesforce, and other data sources. You can use the option to import other data sources to bring offline conversions into Google AdWords. If we select this option, you can see that we can import conversions that are based on people clicking through on our ads, and we can import our own call data. Let's start with conversions from clicks. Using the conversions from clicks option means we need to capture details about the click on our ad that later led to an offline conversion. To do this, we need to capture the GCL ID. This is an ID for the individual click through from our ad. For example, we can capture the GCL ID using a hidden field in our website's lead form. This means that when people submit their details, we'll also receive information about the click on our ad. Once we've captured the GCL ID, we can upload the IDs for the people who have converted offline. This will allow us to see which campaigns have led to offline conversions, including individual keywords and ads. So here's an example of how we could use this for offline conversion tracking. Let's say we're a car dealership and we're offering test drives. As people click through on our ads, we can capture the GCL ID in our booking form. Then when they come into the dealership and test drive the car, we can then find the GCL ID for the people who decide to purchase the car and upload these IDs. This allows us to see the offline transactions inside Google AdWords. We also have the option of uploading conversions that occurred during phone calls. There are a few requirements for this type of conversion, including that we need to be using a Google forwarding number. Once you've identified the calls that have converted, we need to upload details about those calls, including the caller's phone number, the time of the call duration, and the conversion you'd like to track. Finally, I want to cover some of the differences between the dedicated AdWords conversion tracking we've covered today compared to importing conversions from Google Analytics. The way conversions are counted is different between AdWords and Analytics. AdWords allows you to choose to count one conversion per click or multiple conversions. Google Analytics, on the other hand, allows you to count one goal conversion per session and multiple transactions. Both use JavaScript tracking code to collect conversion data. AdWords conversion tracking only includes conversions that came from your ads, while Google Analytics will include all of your marketing channels. Both options allow you to assign a dollar value to a conversion action. And AdWords attributes the conversion to the last ad click, while Analytics attributes them to when the conversion occurred. As we've seen, Google AdWords conversion tracking gives us a range of options to understand the performance of our campaigns, from website conversions through to offline conversions. Remember, you'll see differences in your conversion numbers when you compare Google AdWords to Google Analytics. You have the flexibility of using the dedicated AdWords conversion tracking or importing conversions from Google Analytics. Use the option that meets your needs. So that's how you can track conversions in Google AdWords. Remember, you can use the dedicated Google AdWords conversion tracking, but you can also import conversions from Google Analytics or use a combination of both. The main thing is that you only track a conversion action once into Google AdWords. For example, if you've imported a goal from Google Analytics, then you don't need to track that action using Google AdWords conversion tracking at the same time. This would result in conversions being double counted in AdWords. How are you tracking conversions into Google AdWords? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. And if you haven't already, then watch my video where I cover the 9 biggest AdWords mistakes you need to avoid. I'll see you next time.